नमस्ते, वेलकम टू ग्रीट अरो. सो हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर डूइंग गुड. आई होप यू आर हैविंग एन अमेजिंग डे टुडे. सो इफ यू न्यू हियर, इफ यू लाइक माई कॉन्टेंट, प्लीज सपोर्ट माई चैनल. और इफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी सपोर्टेड मी, थैंक यू सो वेरी मच. इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स आई हैव माई इंस्टाग्राम पेज लिंक. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फॉलो मी देन गो हेड एंड गिव इट अ फॉलो. एंड द टेक्स्ट दैट आई विल बी यूजिंग इन दिस रीडिंग विल ऑल्सो बी लिस्टेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. So today is a candlebacks reading. I'm going to do 3 piles today. Okay. So the topic is what is coming your way, and I'm going to channel a lot of messages for you guys today. So and I'm going to use 2 decks also. Okay. So 3 groups. So close your eyes, relax. I have 3 candles for you guys. For group number 1, we have this yellow one. For group number 2, red. For group number 3, it's green. So close your eyes, relax, and then select a candle or a ball. 1, 2, 3, that calls to you intuitively. The timestamps will be in the description box. If you want more time, take your time and then select. Okay, I'm gonna start with group number 1. So group number 1, if you have chosen the yellow candle, let's see what is coming your way. And for you guys, 232 number might be important. 232. Okay, so just relax guys, I'm gonna pour the water. For some of you, you might be kissing someone. So a lot of kisses, lips. I'm seeing lips. For some of you, you might be taking care of your lips, or maybe you're buying certain things, products for your lips, or maybe you were searching, or maybe someone will gift you something like a lipstick or something like that. Or yeah. And for others, I feel like there is going to be a lot of kisses coming your way. Maybe, yeah, there is some passion. I can see that. A lot of passion between two people. You're going to be very seductive, I'm getting. Like, people will be very attracted to you guys. Okay. So, I'm hearing, like, don't give up on your goals and desires and dreams for someone else. Like, yeah, I'm getting, like, for some of you, it's like choosing between a person or your goals or dreams and desires. I don't know. That's something I'm getting. Like, you need to choose between this person or your dreams or aspiration. So your spirit is telling you to choose wisely. Okay? Do something that is very, very authentic to you guys. Don't do something that is not authentic. Okay? If your dreams or desires are very big for you guys, if that is what you want in your life, don't give up for some person, okay? If this person truly loves you, they will understand that this is your goal, this is your dreams, and they will accept you with that. So don't let that happen. So don't make anyone choose. Like for some of you, yes, yeah, someone is making you choose between two things. And like between them or between your friends or between them or between your goals and desires. So if they truly love you, they will accept you with that thing, right? So yeah, don't do something that you don't want to do. Yeah, if someone is trying to make you do something, and if you're not willing to do it, don't do it. Say no. Someone is getting into makeup, like you used to not do makeup, but you want to do it now. So give it a try. Okay, it's okay. Some of you are planning to buy some flowers. Or for someone, if you want to buy it, go. I'm getting like maybe for some of you, you have a secret admirer. Yeah. You have a secret admirer. I'm getting that. Maybe you might receive a message from this person. Yeah, someone is praying for something. You're praying for something. Like, I want this, you're just praying constantly. And Spirit is saying, wait, you will get it at the correct time. Like, don't be, like, I'm getting, don't be desperate to, like, don't be desperate. I'm getting that energy of, like, yeah, you don't be desperate. Just take it slowly. Yeah, for some of you, you want to go to a beach, you know, you want to spend some quality time with your friends. So just do it, okay? Just do it. It will be very relaxing. I'm like feeling round and round. So maybe like there is a person in your life where you're going in circles with this person, or a situation where you're going in circles. It's time to... It's like Spirit is saying, it's time to learn the lesson and let go of that person. Maybe for some of you, you have seen a pattern with this person. Whatever you do, this person doesn't change. Maybe it's them, it's not you. You cannot change someone, right? So it's important that you take care of your mental health. Make yourself a priority right now and let go of those friends who are doing the same thing again and again. You, like, they do something, you forgive them, and then they do it again, you forgive them. It's like a cycle, it's never ending cycle. So it's time you take your stand and move away from that kind of people. Okay, it's like Spirit is telling you to choose what your heart tells you to do. Okay, don't let anyone make you do something that you don't want to do. That is, I'm getting, like, yeah. Like, even if it's a dress, if you're going to buy a dress, only buy the dress that makes you happy. Don't do because someone else liked that dress. Or yeah, that is something I'm getting here. Maybe you have friends who will be like, oh, this dress is not looking good on you, don't buy that, but you want it. If that's the case, buy the dress that you love, okay, that you want to wear. I feel like Spirit is giving you a lot of messages regarding this person. Some secrets are going to be revealed. I feel like there is someone who is not so trustworthy as you think they are. And I feel like very soon, this person's truth will be out. Like a two-faced person I'm getting here for some of you. Like, they say things very nicely to you, but they are not so happy with it. So for some of you, there is a two-faced person. And I'm getting, like, you feel off with this person. For some of you, intuitively, you feel off. But you are like, oh my God, they're so sweet. How can they be like this? So you disregard your intuition. So don't do that. Trust your intuition. Okay, so something is off here. Someone is, like, just here for their benefit. Yeah, I feel like that truth is going to be revealed and you will be very clear. Like, clarity is coming. So if there is a situation that is going round and round and round, I feel like you will be very clear on what you need to do. Like, maybe for some of you, I feel like you have hit rock bottom. Now it's the time to make a decision, like, about a person. Like, they have been doing this all the time. They have been like repeating the same mistakes, and now you're like, no, I cannot handle this anymore, I cannot do this anymore. So it's like, it's time to stop that and move out from that. Yeah, and focus on yourself, your goals. Maybe because of like other people, you are not able to give 100% to your goals, your desires, your dreams, because they are taking your time. Like, you sit for studying and then they will have some problem, they will call you, and then you have to rush to help them. And it's been like an everyday task for you guys. So maybe now it's important that you focus on yourself rather than them. it's important to help other people. It's very good to help other people to be kind. But when it's like if someone is like using you need to stop doing that, right? If they are like not rec and I even feel like that they don't even recognize your efforts. Maybe when you need some help, they might not come to you as you go to them. So something like that also I'm getting. They will make excuses. Or maybe a job that is taking away so much from you and it's not giving anything in return. So maybe you need to make that decision. What is your heart telling you? Like, be authentic. Maybe for some of you are not authentic with your motives. You're just like doing for the sake of doing it. Maybe it's like maybe you are in a friendship because you feel like this friend of yours will give you something. Don't be like that. Be honest with yourself. Okay, be honest to that. If like yeah, for you guys also, I feel like it's honesty is the best policy. That is what I'm getting here. Yeah. It's not the time to share something. Okay, maybe for some of you have something to share to someone and you're like you want to share it and your spirit is telling no, it's not the time. It's not the time yet. Don't share it. Keep it to yourself. Okay. For some of you, I'm seeing a journey, a beautiful journey is coming your way. Maybe you're planning to travel and it will be very beautiful. Okay. Don't stress about it. And for others, it can be a mental journey. Like you're focusing on your mental health. Like I feel like you are going to focus on your mental health. You're balancing your health. You're concentrating on yourself, your goals. And spirit is telling you to do that right now. Instead of focusing on other people, focus on yourself. Like if someone is taking advantage of you, stop it. Like don't let them take advantage of you. And yes, one more thing is like don't say yes to everything. You cannot do everything. And I even feel like someone is trying to make you do something that you don't want to do. And now it's time to like say no. Okay? I'm seeing a person who is like looking at the stars and like they're eyes are filled and like tears are falling down. So you might be remembering someone who have passed like yeah, who has gone to the other side, and they are like, I feel like there is a message from them that they are safe, they're doing good. Don't worry about them. Now it's time to accomplish the things that you want to accomplish in your life. For some of you, I feel like you will be like sleeping a lot. Maybe you need that sleep. So sleep. Okay, if you want to take that extra nap, just take it. I'm getting a very empty void feeling from you guys. Maybe for some of you feeling very void, very empty or very dissatisfied in some area of your life. Like some area, not every area. Maybe for some of you your career is not going the way you want. For some of your relationship is not going the way you want. Some area of your life you're feeling very void. And spirit is telling you be grateful for all the things you have and just work on your goals, okay? And of course if when it's a relationship, it's important that you tell your needs, speak up for yourself. If it's a friend who is taking advantage of you, don't let them do that, okay? Sometimes people feel like that we have to be for them, right? Maybe your friends are like, you have to be with them. Whenever they're feeling challenged, you have to support them. You know, sometimes you need that support. And I feel like you have problems asking for other people's support. You do it everything by yourself and everyone relies on you. Maybe it's too much on your sh it's like it's he it's like very heavy for you guys. So I feel like you need to take that extra nap, and if your friends are calling you, say that I don't want to go out today. It's okay. You don't have to be present everywhere, right? I'm getting like this feeling, like make yourself a priority now. Spirit is telling, like for at least for 1 week or 2 weeks, just make yourself a priority. Take extra breaks for yourself. If you don't want to go to work, just take one extra day. You're maybe was like you're those people who never take a break. Like even if you don't like feel good health-wise, you will never take a break from your work. And here Spirit is telling you to take a break. Or maybe you have a lot of responsibilities and that's why you feel like that, you can never take a break. But ask for help, ask for support. Let others do something for you, okay? That's something I'm getting here for some of you. I'm getting a very void feeling from you guys. Like there is some dissatisfaction going on in your life. And your spirit is saying that's just that will be only for some period. It's just a temporary thing. You're not going to feel like this forever. Don't think like that, okay? It's just a temporary thing. Everything will come back. So that's why they're telling you to take that extra nap, to focus on your health, your mental health. If you feel you need to talk to someone, if you feel like you need to consult a therapist, or maybe for some of you it's like watching like positive things, like watching like tarot readings also. I feel like it will boost your energy, it will help you, it will give you motivation, or watch some motivational videos, or read something that makes you happy, okay? Or watch some comedy movies. So that's something here I'm getting. I feel for some of you, your confidence was questioned. Like you were very confident in something, and something bad happened, and that's why now you lack a little bit of confidence. So your spirit is telling you that, yeah, that happened, but that doesn't mean in the future it will happen. So don't, yeah, be confident in yourself. Don't lose confidence, okay? Like when a kid, like I'm getting a kid who has to recite a poem in the stage, like, and they go and they're very confident at first, but then they don't remember the entire poem, and then they have fear of getting into, like, stage fear, like that kind of energy. Then they're not confident to go again on the stage. Don't let that happen. Do it again. Try until you succeed. That kind of energy I'm getting here. Like I'm getting, like for some of you, shame, guilt. That's something we feel. Like don't let that come get into you guys, okay? Yeah, failure is just a part of life. Through failure only we learn, right? Failure is just a part of life. I feel like that. If it gets to you, that is the problem. Then only the problem will come. Just say, yeah, I didn't, I couldn't do it the first time, but I will try again. Yeah, I will try my best again. That's it. That's the thing. Instead of giving it up entirely, right? Like maybe you prepared for an exam, you did your best, but you didn't get the result you wanted, but you can try again. That's what Spirit is telling. Don't let failure get into you. Okay, so yeah, let's just pull out some cards for you guys to end the reading. First, I'm just going to pull out some Buddha reading cards. So let's see what the wisdom you need right now. What is the wisdom? What you need to know right now, what is the wisdom that you need right now? This is a contemplation card. It's about karma. The more you practice karma, the more you will discover that you are the master of your own fortune and the creator of your own destiny. इन इट्स सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म कर्मा इम्प्लाइज कॉज एंड इफेक्ट. कर्मा कैन गिव यू द करेज टू लुक डीपर इन टू योर पास्ट एक्शन एंड टेक फुल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज फॉर योर लाइफ एज इट इज अनफोल्डिंग. नोइंग दैट यू प्लांटेड द कार्मिक सीड्स इन द पास्ट, फ्लावर्स ऑफ वीड्स, फॉर्चुनेट और अनफॉर्चुनेट, दे आर ऑल देयर विद यू. सो हियर दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, दे आर टेलिंग यू टू कॉन्टेम्पलेट हियर. सो दैट इज द विजडम अबाउट योर कर्मा. सो द एक्शन, लाइक if you are working hard, if you are trying your best, if you are planting a positive thoughts, you will get it back, right? So what you give, you will get it back. So that's the thing I was talking about, to be 100% authentic to yourself, right? So do something that you want to do it. Like for the sake of showing to other people, don't do anything. Like if you want to help someone, do it with pure intention. Yeah, I really want to help someone. But like don't do because you feel like you need to do, or you, or maybe you have just a motive for doing that. Like be honest with yourself, because karma is there. So what you give, you receive. So that's something here, it's coming here, okay? And if you have been working hard on something, nothing is going to go away from you. You will reap that rewards, okay? Because what you give out to the universe, you will get it back. That's what here your message is. And let's see this also, what's coming your way. What's coming your way? Fruit number one. We have goblin. So a lot of fear-based energy. You need to, like goblins, like these are some fear-based energy I'm getting for you guys. You're overthinking about certain things you're stressing about, or yeah, as I told you, failure. Maybe you're stressing about your failure. Maybe you have failed in the past. Now you are very afraid to do things because you feel that you will fail, and that fear is not good. You need to let go of the fear. If you think about the fear, if you are always imagining that you will fail, that is the thing you're giving to the universe, right? That energy you're giving, and you might get it back. So that's the thing you need to know right now. If you believe in yourself, if you take action accordingly, if you're honest with yourself, like if you're like, I will not give up, I'll try my best, and if you're confident, you will receive that back. But if you are like, no, I cannot do this, I'm a failure, I will not be able to do this, like every relationship fails, my entire life is a failure, if you're constantly thinking that, it will come back to you in different ways. You will see that thing. So that's what spirit is telling you right now. That is the wisdom for you guys right now, okay? So that's all I have for group number one. Bye bye, take care. Group number two, if you have chosen the red candle, let's see what is your message, what's coming your way. Let's see. So I'm just gonna pour the water, so relax guys. Someone over here is very nervous. Very nervous, why? You're nervous about something. Okay, let's see. For you guys, your number is like 457. I channeled the number for you guys, 457. Just, if you can just, research about it, if you want to, you can, but I like got 457, and it's like sharing your feelings. Yeah, for some of you, you want to share your feelings to someone and you're very nervous about it, like what this person will say. Will they say yes or no? Whatever the outcome is, like spirit is telling you to share the feelings instead of worrying. Oh, two things came together. Like things are coming together. Wow, that was beautiful. Like these two things, like just they came together. Things are coming together. So for some of you, definitely, you might get proposed, or you will say your feelings to someone, and you will that person will also feels the same way you do. So yeah, there is some sort of love energy here for you guys. Yeah, love. Sharing your feelings, or maybe you had a fight with someone, you are like reconciling, like reconciliation I'm getting, like you're coming back, like it can be a friend, You had a fight with your friend, you're very nervous about it, but finally you share your thoughts and you are coming back together. Okay, that's something I'm getting here. Like a lot of protection also, umbrella, maybe the weather. Maybe for some of you when you're going out, I don't know why, but like for some of you it's like keep an umbrella with you. Maybe the weather will change and you will need it. Okay, and or it is also like a protection. I'm seeing a peacock. Oh my god, peacock, it's like you're going to be feeling very attractive. So maybe you have bought a new dress or something, just wear it and you will be looking very good. Okay, so for some of you, like, yeah, or maybe you will go shopping and you will get a very beautiful dress and you will look very good in it. And yes, there will be a lot of people who will be like seeing you. Yeah, you're going to be very feeling very attractive. People will be noticing you. If you're single, definitely I feel like a lot of people, if you are noticing you, even if you're not single, I feel like a lot of people will be noticing you because you will be looking very good. Like there is a glow up, and this you know, the dress, I feel like for some of you have a dress that you have bought recently and it's like very beautiful and it looks so good on you, and people will be like complimenting you for that. Okay, so that's something, like a lot of compliments I'm getting. Yeah, so enjoy that, take that compliments. Okay, it's okay to do that, right? Sometimes we disregard what they are saying, it's not like that, you know, sometimes we do that. Take that, it's okay to feel good about yourself, and it's a good thing, I guess. And I'm like seeing a letter J. For some of you, J letter might be a clue here. J, okay. Or maybe for your dreams, you have seen someone, like in your dreams you saw someone, some person that you haven't seen in real life. Like, yeah, something about your dreams, like some prophet. Maybe for some of you, you have seen a dream that you are thinking about, like something you see, you have seen in your dream might come true. That's a very specific message here. Okay. Okay, for some of you, you're going out, having fun with your friends, like eating ice cream or something like that also I'm getting. You're taking care of your hair. Like maybe for some of you have a celebration coming up or a party, so you're buying this dress, you're like taking care of your hair, you're like thinking about the new hairstyle. So just do, just you are look going to look very good, don't worry. Okay, for some of you, maybe you are, it's your wedding day or something like that. And I feel like maybe for some of you, you will meet a person in the celebration. Yeah, maybe for some of you have a celebration coming up. Okay. And there you will meet a friend or a potential partner. Like, yeah, that's something I feel here. Like you're planning to braid your hair, like different hairstyles you're looking at. So go, yeah, it'll look good. Do what you feel like. That's the message here. It's a very different message today. It's like about your beauty. You're focusing too much on your beauty. Like you want to feel very good about yourself. You want to feel look beautiful. Yes, you will. That's what spirit is saying. People will notice you. Nine number might be important for some of you. I'm seeing a nine number. It's like completion of a cycle. Like, yeah, mastering something. For some of you, have a lot of talents. Like, a lot of talents. Like, and you feel like that you're not mastering anything because you can do everything. So you want to, like, you want to do one thing, but you don't know what you need to do. Like, because you have talents in everything. So I feel like for some of you, you will be very clear on what you need to do next. Yeah, I'm getting like you will make a decision. You will make a decision in the future about that. You will not be confused. Like, yes, I have talents in this thing, but I'm gonna go with this one. Like, you're going to select one and you're gonna go with that one. Yeah, there is no confusion anymore. So things are becoming very clear for you guys. So, like if you are very confused about what dress you need to wear or what kind of hairstyle you want, you will not be confused, okay? So yeah, everything will be okay. You will be very clear on what you want. I'm seeing like a bathtub for some of you. Maybe you will be relaxing, you will have a very good bath, okay? Or maybe you will, yeah, maybe for some of you it's like booking a hotel room and spending some quality time there with your friends or with your partner. So that's something I'm getting here. Like some relaxing time, definitely. Some celebration, or maybe it's your birthday coming up, so you'll be like you're planning dresses for your birthday, like that's why you're very confused. You want to look good, and yes, you will be looking good, you will be enjoying a good time. I'm seeing a very good time coming your way, okay? Okay. Like I'm just getting a quote here. What you seek is seeking you. What you seek is seeking you, guys. So what you want? Like I feel like you're doing the correct thing. You're doing manifestations. You're imagining things the way you want. And yeah, you are doing your best. I feel like that. So now you're ready to, like, I feel like you're over someone. You're over your past, you're over your ex, and now you're like ready to mingle. For some of you, it's like that I'm getting. And yes, things will be good. Don't worry. There is a lot of nervousness I'm getting, like, for you guys. Don't be afraid because everything will be good for you guys. Don't worry, okay? For some of you, it's like whether this thing will arrive at correct time, whether I'll be able to do this thing at the correct time. Like you're overstressing about it. Like you're very nervous because you want everything very good, very nice. Everything will be okay. Don't stress. Okay. Anything else? Yeah, there's a heart here. Definitely love. A lot of love. Like, you are going to be very pampered here. Yeah, people are pampering you. I'm getting that. You're feeling over the top and people are pampering you. You're feeling good about yourself. People are complimenting you, that kind of thing. Like maybe you did something and people are very proud of you. Maybe your parents will be very proud of you. That kind of energy I'm getting here. And yeah, this like I'm feeling like you are proud of yourself as well. For some of you, it can be like, yes, I got up, I got from my bed, I just dressed up, I went out, so you're proud of yourself. That can be also the thing, right? It can be simple things like you wear. In your house, you were not doing any socializing. Finally, you're doing that, so you're proud of yourself. Like, look at a big heart. Yeah, that definitely there's a lot of love. Definitely, if you're single, I feel like you're ready to, like, a lot of people are like attracted to you, or maybe you will go to a party, someone will talk to you, and you will like click. I'm getting that kind of energy here. I'm like seeing a lot of smiles for you guys. A lot of smiling is happening. I don't know, I'm getting this song, it's a Hindi song. Like, do dil mil rahe hai, chupke chupke, some sort of. Like, I'm getting that song. Oh, maybe someone has a one-sided crush here. And I finally, this person will say yes. Ah, I told you, yeah. This person also feels the same. That's what I'm getting. So don't be nervous. Okay, so let's see. Let's take cards. So I'm just using this Buddha cards to let's see what wisdom you need to know right now. Like wisdom from Buddha, what you need to know. Okay, let's see. What is the wisdom they need in their life right now? Group number two. What wisdom they need right now in their life? Okay. It's a cultivation. I feel like it's a cultivation card, and what I'm getting is like to love yourself more. It's about self-love I'm getting here. That is what you need to cultivate more in your life. Like to feel beautiful, to feel worthy. Like, yes, you're doing good. Yes, I am feeling good. Yes, I'm beautiful. Like maybe for some of you, you have, like you don't feel beautiful. You feel like that you're not so beautiful. Everyone around you is beautiful, but you're not that beautiful. You constantly compare yourself to other people. So maybe that is what you need to cultivate. Like that what you need to cultivate is like self-love and feel like that. Yes, you are also beautiful, that I am also worthy. I'm good the way I am. So that's what you need to cultivate, as well as loving kindness. So it's like, be kind to yourself more. Talk beautifully to yourself more. You know, I feel like you're the ones who give very, like you're very kind to other people. If someone dresses beautifully, you say, wow, you look good. At the same time, you don't compliment yourself. Like, it's important that you are kind to yourself as well as you're kind to other people. And it can be also that be kind to others also. Like, though sometimes our tongue is like a sword, right? If we say something to someone, think before we say. Like, you didn't like the dress and you say like, this is not looking good, maybe they will feel very bad. So don't be like that. So be more kind. Okay, for some of you that is also the message. So when we feel love and kindness towards other, it not only makes others feel loved and cared for, but it also helps us to develop inner happiness and peace. So it's all about giving that love and kindness to others. But what I first felt for you guys is like, you need to give that love and kindness to yourself as well. Okay. Loving kindness is the distilled essence of pure love. As you open your heart, you are able to love the unlovable, bring joy to sadness, faith to doubt, and light to darkness. Wow. So there is a lot of love coming your way. That's what I feel like. And you need to love yourself more, as well as be kind to other. Use kind words. I'm feeling like it's like you need to use kind words to yourself as well. For this group, that's what I'm feeling like. And if someone out there, you know, in this group, if you say things without thinking, like, don't hurt other people through your words. Sometimes our words cut people, right? So use it wisely. That's also I'm getting here. You know, if you're going out, just smile. And maybe someone needs that. Show that kindness. That's something Spirit is telling you guys. So let's see what else is coming your way. We have cleaning house. Okay. So with this, so for some of you, this is a message to clean your house. Maybe your house is literally very messy. So maybe you will be cleaning your house this next week, or that's what is coming your way. You will have to clean your office area, your house, your wardrobe, or maybe it's time to declutter all the clothes that you're not using. It's time to give away the clothes that you're not using, and as well as to clean up the emotions that are not good for you guys. Maybe you think that you're not worthy enough, that you are not good enough. And that's why for some of you, you have like, there is a party, everyone will be looking good. Will I look good? So maybe you're thinking, you're overstressing about it. Let go of that emotions. You're good the way you are. Yes, definitely, I feel like next week you will be cleaning a lot. You will be cleaning your house a lot. I'm like cleaning your house. Or maybe it's a message or it's a sign from Spirit to clean your house. Whenever you're feeling very stressed, clean your house. It will make you feel very good. Okay. So, when our house is organized, when our house energy is good, when the smell is good in our house, we also feel good, right? So if your house is messy, if your work area is messy, so you will also feel very messy. So it's important that you clean your house, okay? So that's it for group number two. Bye-bye. Take care. Group number three, if you have chosen this green candle, let's see what is your message, what is coming your way. So let's see. So for you guys, I gave a number for every pile. So for you guys, it's 375. Maybe you can just Google it. I just channeled this number. So relax, guys. So let's see what is your message. Okay. Take a deep breath, guys. I feel like you need to do that. like breathing exercises will help you a lot. Okay, I'm just feeling like cleansing for you guys. Maybe you need to protect your space, you need to cleanse your space. If you're doing spiritual work, like if you are like spiritual, if you do spiritual work or something like that, please cleanse your home. Or maybe it's a message to cleanse your home, clean your space. Okay, like use sage, or if you don't have sage, use incense or whatever you can. If you like, yeah, Palo Santo. So yeah, I feel like there are people around you who take your energy a lot. I'm getting. Without even knowing, they take your energy. So maybe you need to protect yourself, okay? Or maybe you use like white light meditation, or call upon Archangel Michael. Yeah, Archangel Michael, I'm getting for you guys. So he will help you with that. Okay, let's start. I'm feeling for some of you, you need to get some sunlight, some vitamin D. Maybe you need to go to a beach or something like that. Like get some sunlight. Yeah. Or maybe you have, like maybe you need to consult doctor or take a test for your vitamin D. I'm getting, yeah, some vitamin D issues for some of you. Yeah, let's see. Like get some sunlight. Or maybe it's like you're seeing the sunlight, like a lot of creative ideas are coming your way. That's also something possible, okay? And don't resist anything, flow like water. Don't try to control anything. I feel like you need to only think about what you need to do for the next 24 hours. Make a plan for just for next 24 hours. Whenever you feel lost, do that. Oh, I feel like big things are coming your way, guys. I'm getting that energy. Big things. Something big is coming your way. Maybe you have dreamt about it. Like something big is coming. Something big is coming. Yeah, something big is definitely coming. I'm getting fish. A lot of fish. Like your emotions. Your emotions are very important. The way you feel is very important. For some of you, I feel like you have the ability of clairsentience. So whenever you see someone, like you can feel their emotions. Right? So trust that. And I feel for many of you, you need to write down what you're feeling, your emotions. You need to work on your emotions as well, right? Take a journal, write down what you're feeling. Like maybe in your dream time, you felt something, write it down. Because this is a message from spirit, I'm getting. Like your emotions are very important. Don't resist, you know, don't take your, like you might feel something off. Why I'm feeling like this? And maybe you will just, It's I don't have to worry about it or something like that. You'll feel like you will just disregard your emotions. Maybe don't do that. Like write it down. Write down your emotions. Maybe that there is a message for you guys. For some of you, I feel like that. With this fish, that is what I'm getting. And fish is also like maybe for some of you, like you're getting a message, to do something. Like you're feeling like I need to do this. I need to go out and meet this person. Maybe you're feeling that. And you don't do it. So spirit here is telling you that that is a message from spirit and do it. If you're feeling like, yes, you need to meet this person, go ahead. Go and do it. If you feel like that, yes, I need to do this today. Like you're an artist and you feel like, yeah, I need to paint this today. Just paint it. Like if you have been feeling it, do it. Okay? Because your feelings... your feelings are very important. It's like it's a way of communication from spirit that you're getting. Yeah, that's how spirit communicates to you. I'm getting for some of you, that's how spirit communicates to you, through your feelings. I'm getting this clairsentience energy here for you guys. Like you might be clairsentient. Or yeah, if you're trying to develop your spiritual gifts, keep on moving with it, because you're going to expand a lot. Yeah, there is a lot of expansion here for you guys. Spiritual. I feel like you're very spiritual and like a lot of spiritual progress is what I see for you guys. If you have a spiritual career, you will see progress. You are going to see progress. Maybe your progress is very slow and spirit is telling that there was a reason for that. Sometimes you questioned because you were not moving forward. Like you saw everyone is moving forward, they're doing their best, they are developing their gifts, and you're feeling like, oh my God, I'm very slow, I'm not progressing at all. It's like it was, there was a reason for that, okay? At the correct time, there was a lot of progress happening for you guys, like movement, progress. Like things are moving forward for you guys, finally, that's what I see. I feel like you will feel very happy also with your progress. Like if you're not happy right now with your progress, the way you're moving forward, I see what is coming your way is like you will feel very, very happy by your progress, the way you're progressing, the speed also. You'll be very happy by the speed also, the things are progressing. Maybe in your relationship, things are not progressing the way you want. Things will progress. So there is progress, movement, spiritual progress, relationship progress, career progress. So whatever progress you want, that's coming your way, okay? Or maybe it's your own progress, like your growth. You felt like you are not growing as a person. Finally, you're growing. You're feeling good about it also. Developing certain abilities. Maybe for some of you, are taking online courses. You're trying to develop something. You're going to get better at it. If you're doing that, you're going to get better and better at it. Someone is drinking a lot of coffee, I feel like that. So maybe you need to cut it down, okay? Yeah, it's like spirit is telling you to get out of your comfort zone. Do something daring. I'm getting like, for some of you, you have this idea that is very daring. And you're like, whether should I do it or not? This is so daring. This is not in my comfort zone. It's like spirit is telling, do it. Do it anyways. Don't be so caught up about the outcome. Don't worry about the outcome. Just do it. Go for it. Take that further gate. I'm getting like that. Go for it. Get out of your comfort zone. Because that will lead to you, your progress. Okay? For some of you, it's like saying something, some truth. Like if your friend has been living a life full of lies, like they are not being their authentic self or they are faking something. So maybe it's time for you guys to say that what you're doing is not correct. Like give them show them that the truth. Yeah, like if you feel like you need to show them the truth, show them. Like, yeah, I'm like your friends are doing something that is not beneficial for them, that is harming them. So show them that, tell them that this is not the way, like tell the truth. That's something I'm getting, like speaking your mind, speaking your truth. Yeah, it might hurt them, but it will be for their own best. Maybe they're doing something that is not good at all. Their behavior is not good. Maybe you will tell them this is not nice. This is not the way it should be. Maybe it will hurt them, but it will be for their own good. I'm getting like that. I feel you're empaths. Some of you are empaths. Like, you take other people's energy a lot. Like, if your friend is feeling sad. You feel it. So maybe that's the thing. You need to protect yourself. Class sentience, empaths. I'm getting that. Yeah, you feel it. So that's why it's like, I was like cleansing my space for your reading. Like, yeah, maybe you need to cleanse your space, your work, yourself every day. Do some protection mantra or use white light meditation. Yeah. Surround yourself with this protective energy. You need it a lot. It's not because people want to harm you or they are sending you that bad vibes. No, it's not that, because it's like without them knowing, they do that. Okay, for some of you, I feel like that. Without they are like they don't even think, but they give that energy, that negative vibes. You absorb it very easily. You absorb things that is not yours. You absorb that energy very easily. So yeah, you need to protect yourself. I'm getting this empath vibes from you guys. So you are focusing on your spiritual development. I feel like keep on focusing. You're developing your character. You're becoming a better version of yourself. You're trying to better yourself daily. You're doing that inner work. You're doing that shadow work. For some of you, I'm even getting like you're doing that inner child healing. right? This pile is like you're working on yourself. You're trying to better yourself. You're becoming more kinder to yourself and others. But at the same time, you need to share that truth also, okay? So when we share the truth at first, people might get hurt. They might be like, it's like if you're a medium, or if you're a, like just an example, if you're a medium or if you are a person who gives messages to other people, like you might say something that might hurt them, and they'll be like, why are you saying that? This is not for me. And they might turn their back, but I feel like they will come back to you and they will be like, yeah, you were correct. What you said was correct. Like they will recognize your talent. I feel like that. Okay, your friends also, maybe you will tell something to your friends and they will not like it, but later they will come to you because they will recognize that, yes, you were right, what you said was right. And that I'm getting that kind of energy because you're working on yourself, you're making a very strong connection with the divine. Okay, this pile is really very spiritual. And I'm getting this green color also. You chose this green color also. Green for me is also about healing, right? So maybe for some of your healers, your psychics. So in some way, you're helping other people. But sometimes your messages might not be taken nicely. Like they will feel like, what are you saying? You're just like, they might question you. But they will come back. They will understand that later. Like that I'm getting. You know, and you know, you don't, yeah, sometimes people will say bad to you guys. Don't take it to your heart because they don't know. They are not aware as you are, right? So don't worry about it. Don't take that energy. So that's why you need to have this. I'm seeing a money bag. Oh, wow. And we had this fish. Fish is also about abundance, isn't it? So yeah, money bag. So definitely there is financial progress for you guys. Okay. I can see that very clearly. So maybe for some of you, you want for financial progress also. That's coming. I'm seeing a rabbit also as well. So things are going to progress. Yeah. A lot of animals I'm feeling. Like maybe you have a connection with the animals. Like you're seeing a lot of animals. So maybe this is a sign from spirit. They're showing you something. So be open to that also. For some of you, you want to heal animals in some way, go for it. And I'm seeing a letter L for some of you. Like it's a glass bag, okay? And then there is a L. Like a lot of insects also I'm seeing here. Yeah, bees. So like your hard work is paying off, don't worry. Sometimes we don't see, right? But it's happening. Universe is with you. So L letter might be important to you guys, okay? L. Maybe it's a clue for some of you. L letter. If that is, comment down. What is it? I'm very curious to know. Or maybe it's a name of yours, or I don't know. But something L, okay? Like for some of you, you have been seeing a lot of water in your dreams. It's about your emotions, okay? Take note of your emotions, journal it down. So yeah, what you're feeling is, your feelings are very important. That's what I'm getting here, okay? So that's it. So I'm just gonna pull some cards for group number 3. So let's see what the, you know, wisdom from Buddha. Let's see what's your wisdom? What wisdom you need in your life right now? What is the message for group number 3? Let's see. Oh my God, that was a lot. Oh my God, it's like mothering yourself. That's what I heard. You're kind of mothering yourself. It's time to mother yourself. It's time to, like as a mother gives without expectations, right? She just keep doing so much. So maybe you need to do your, you need to do things without expecting anything. For some of you, it's like that. Okay, let's see. The cards just flew out. I'm just taking one card, okay? Let's see what is the wisdom that group 3 needs the most right now. Okay. Okay, we have this meditation post. For some of you, definitely, So some of you, this post might be important. Okay, just look at it. Okay, I feel like you might receive some messages. Like, just look at this photo. If you receive some messages, take that messages. Okay, maybe this pose is important for you guys. While meditating, use this pose. So let's see. Pure concentration. Yes. Thought is energy. Active thought. Interestingly, what I thought, you know, your emotions, your feelings, like your thoughts, like what you feel is very important, right? So that's a message here. Okay, I'm getting like that one. I'm just getting a confirmation. Like for some of your clients and clients. Like your emotions, the feelings that you have, like the thoughts, you know, you get random thoughts out of nowhere. Maybe that's a message for some of you. Like it's a message from spirit. Trust it. Okay, and let's see, what is this? We have pure concentration. It's a purity card, so you need to have pure concentration. Also, for some of you, you might get into negative thinking also. That's what you need to let go of. Okay, thought is energy. Active thought is active energy. Concentrated thought is concentrated energy. Thought concentrated on a definite purpose becomes power. So if you want to manifest something in your life, you like concentrate, like what you want to manifest, just focus on that. Awareness comes from the purity of concentration. This enables you to honor the rising and falling of things without getting caught in the downward spiral of destructive emotions. Consciously focus on where your mind is in relation to what reality is. For some of you, as I told you, emotions are very important. You have been feeling that emotions. For some of you, it's like a lot of negative emotions are coming your way. That's why I told you to have a journal, write it down. So you need to know what you need to let go of, what kind of emotions that are not good for you guys, you need to let go of. Okay, that is the message also here. You need to purify. Like maybe for some of you, you think a lot. Overthinking. So yeah, the thoughts that you don't need in your life, let it go. Okay, and we know when we stress, we are not able to. For some of you, that is also the thing. You stress a lot, and because of it, you don't trust the emotions that you feel because of your negative thinking. So sometimes that's why you are not able to receive the messages from spirit. So you need to let go of that negative thoughts here. For some of you, it's time to listen. Listening, look, we have listening here. You need to listen to spirit. Maybe for some of you, through music, you might receive a lot of messages. Okay, yeah, your message you will receive through music. For some of you, that is the thing. You need to listen to spirit, like listen to your own emotions. For some of you, it's like, what are you thinking? What kind of thoughts you have? Is it negative? Is it positive? Is this thought helpful for you guys? Or it's not helpful, right? For some of you, you need to work on that, okay? And for others, it's also like, it's the time to listen to other people. Or maybe it's just time to listen to music, relax, listen to some meditation music, or listen to music if some music is playing in your head constantly, maybe there is a message for you guys from spirit. So it's time to listen, okay? So that's all for group number 3. Bye-bye. Take care.